Welcome friends once again to our first video in this series of creating a news-like application with Ionic, Angular and Firebase. In this video I will be taking you step by step on how to set up our working environment so that we can focus more on creating and developing our mobile application. Ionic framework is an open source UI toolkit for building high quality mobile and desktop applications using web technologies such as HTML, CSS and JavaScript. Also, we have to know that Ionic focuses more on front-end user experience. Also, Ionic as a framework does not work as an independent framework, but it has an integration with other frameworks. In the past, Ionic has been integrated with only Angular framework, but as of recent, Ionic 4 has come with an integration of React Native. Those who have heard about React Native and also Angular and Vue.js also has been integrated into Ionic. As we speak now, Ionic depends entirely on your framework's official tooling for building and routing of the application. If you have knowledge of React Native, if you have knowledge of Vue, you can bring that knowledge and use and build an application with Ionic, because your platform or your framework has been embedded into Ionic. So you can Ionic depends entirely on your framework's official tooling for building and the routing of the mobile application or desktop application. That means you will use Angular CLI when using Ionic with Angular and so on. Someone may ask, what is a CLI? A CLI is simply a command line interface that is being embedded with each framework that you use. So if you are using Angular, you'll use Angular CLI on Angular, and then you are using React, you'll use React CLI on React. So that being said, let's dive into the code and see how we can install and start using Ionic in our application. So as you see, Ionic, when we go to installation of Ionic, we have a good documentation that Ionic has provided us. You'll find the link in the description. See how you can install Ionic on your PC. So here we have an installation which is npm install negative g Ionic. So if you know you don't have any you don't have Ionic on your PC and it's the first time you are installing it, make sure your npm is installed on your PC for you to be able to install Ionic using npm. As I was saying, if you don't have Node installed on your PC, you'll find hard time installing Ionic because you will not have some command line command line interfaces like npm that will enable you to install Ionic on your PC. So you go on Node website, you'll find the link in the description. And if you are on Windows, you select Windows, and if you're on Mac, the server will detect automatically the operating system that you are on. But if you say it's not that, then you can go on downloads and then select, if you're on Mac, there is 64-bit for Mac, and for Windows there is 64, 32, and you can install respectively on your machine and install Node. And after installing Node, you will be able to have npm command line embedded into your system, and you can be able to install Ionic. So if you have Node and npm installed on your machine, you'll just go into your command line and then run Ionic npm install Ionic G onto your machine. So let's go ahead and do that. You go on your terminal and say npm install G Ionic on your machine, and then you click enter. This will run and install the latest Ionic, which is current. Okay, so on my machine I'm on Mac, and then it is requiring me to apply permissions, so I need to run it as an administrator. So on Mac it will be sudo then npm install negative g Ionic. So that's what I will run. Then it will ask me the password, then I put in the password over my admin, and then it will install. Good, successfully installed. So after that one is installed, so after that we can start our Ionic application. So there we'll say Ionic start, then we can name our package as news app, and we name it a blank. Okay, let's say type of Angular. So it's going to be an Angular project, that's why we specify the type, since for us we're going to focus more on Angular framework, using and integrating Ionic with Angular framework. So that being done, then we can press enter, and then they give us different packages, startup application that have been made for us. For example, like there is a default template for tabs, and there is side menu. All these ones are default templates for the app that you can use for beginning, for starting. Instead of starting from scratch, from a blank application, you can start with those default application that have been embedded. But for our sake, since we want to know how we can come up with an application from totally a blank page, we'll just select blank, and then they will ask us, okay, pass bar. So npm install is installing our Ionic project. So our project has been installed successfully. Okay, so we can say, we can go to our newly created project, which will be, you say cd, cd is change the directory, cd change the directory, and we go to the directory of our newly created application, which will be news dot, then you enter and it will open to launch the application into a VS Code. If you don't have VS Code installed on your machine, you'll go into the browser and then type in Google. VS Code. You'll find the link into the description. Just click on the link for Visual Studio Code, then it will bring you. Then you'll go onto download, and then you see there is for Windows and for Mac. So if you want to install, if you're on Windows, you can click and install on Windows. You just click here, Mac, you go on Mac and then click install. So the download will start in a very short time. Go ahead, but the link is in the description. You can go and download. So here we are ready with our application. We have dependencies, different dependencies for Angular. So that's why you see, when you use npm, you can install completely actually anything out there. You can install softwares, you can install packages. So npm is an important command line package that we need to use to install different packages. From now on, we'll be using npm as we'll be installing different other packages and dependencies. And as I told you, that Ionic framework used for developing, for building high quality mobile and desktop application using a web technologies such as HTML, CSS and JavaScript. So as you see here, we have HTML page.page, home.page.html, and we have home.page.css, which is same as CSS.